Hello, my name is Sally Gillies, and today I'm going to give you a little snippet from a talk I give on cruises down to Antarctica called Stop So I Can Shoot You. It's actually part of a presentation where I talk about how to take better photographs on your once-in-a-lifetime voyage. I like to give this talk, as frequently I find others give vanity talks, and they'll show you stunning pictures they've taken in Antarctica or in other work locations they've been to, but they don't tell you how they actually got that shot. For instance, this may look like a great shot of some king penguins, nuzzling each other, but in reality, I just happened to be sitting down near my backpack when they came up and started pecking it. More often, I'm like you, and I take wonderful shots like this, where I have a funny blue-grey tint on the entire picture, I have a blob sitting in the middle of nowhere, and really, you just have to say at the end of the day, this is a very unflattering shot of a Weddell seal. When I give this talk in fall, I talk about a number of rules that will help you take better photographs on your cruise or even any general photographic situation. The first one I talk about is the rule of thirds, and I'll be going to that a little bit later in this talk. Another thing I talk about are horizon lines, which are very important when you're on a cruise ship. I talk about sunsets and how to maximize getting all those full and glorious colors on your photographs. I talk about camera filters, should you use them down in somewhere like Antarctica, and even can your camera use filters. I also talk about shades of grey, how to make sure you don't end up with pictures of grey or blue snow, and the same would apply if you're taking pictures of sandy beaches. I also tell you how to frame people in pictures so that you can actually take a more attractive shot of someone who may not be the most photogenic person on the planet. And if at the end of the day you've still got an average shot, well, we can doctor the evidence because this is the digital age. Now, getting back to that first rule I mentioned, which is the rule of thirds. Most people will pick their camera up, see something attractive, and just center the object of their attraction in the middle and take a picture. But in reality, your picture may be enhanced more if you use the rule of thirds, which basically means you divide your picture up as if it's got a tic-tac-toe grid along it, and you try and get your object now so that it is centered along one of those lines, one of those two vertical lines or two horizontal lines, instead of being in the center of your image. And in this instance here, I have a beautiful picture of glaciated Antarctica, and I've got where the mountains meet the ocean lining up along the bottom horizontal line. Uh-oh. Tic-tac-toe's taken over. Who's going to win? The crosses have won. So this might be your standard shot if you were down there. You've seen a picture of a gentoo, or you've seen an opportunity to take a picture of a gentoo, and he's got his little chick huddled up down there for warmth. So you just picked up your camera and you just lined up that penguin and you shot it. But look, it's in the center of the image. Already we're not following the rule of thirds. It's a great picture that cannot be denied, but can it be improved? Well, actually, if you'd lined it up along one of those lines, the horizontal or vertical lines, yes, it probably could have been improved. Here I've lined up the penguin now along the right vertical line, and now he's looking into the picture as well, so we can actually see a bit of the gentoo rookery behind him. Also managed to coincide the glaciated landscape behind him where it meets the water along the top horizontal line. So now I have a picture which not only is a stunning shot of our penguin, but I can actually see what the penguin is doing and what landscape it's sitting in. Here's an example of where you have a seal lined up along those rule of thirds, but what is he looking at? This is where it's really important to make sure, especially when taking pictures of animals, that you do have them looking into the shot, not looking out to the edge of the picture. Here I have a picture of a Weddell seal. Again, I've used my rule of thirds. Most of the seal's body is lined up along that bottom horizontal line, and I've tried to get his eyes along the left vertical line. So I'm using that rule of thirds to make this a stronger shot than just a picture of an entire Weddell seal. Same applies when you're taking pictures of people. If I just centered these people in the middle of this picture, it probably would not have been anywhere near as dramatic. But now that I've actually got them lined up at the intersection there of the bottom horizontal line and the right vertical line, and I've got them looking into the picture, we can see that they're looking into an absolutely stunning glaciated landscape. Here again, we've used the rule of thirds, and I've lined up the again the horizon line. This is the point where the glaciated mountains meet the water with that top horizontal line, and as a result we've got all the beautiful crushed ice floating on the water there in the foreground. So it's a much stronger picture for having been centered along the, one of those powerful rules of third lines. Of course, there are exceptions to the rule of thirds. I would say reflections have to be that. If you have a calm day in Antarctica and you've got calm water, or anywhere where you have calm water and reflections, you may want to rethink that rule of thirds. The picture here, the horizon line, might be best in the middle. And to give you an example of that, this is a nice shot that I've took. I've lined up my horizon line along the bottom horizontal line. It's okay. Nothing special, got some nice colours in it. Looks a bit weirder if I lined up the horizon line with the top horizontal line now. I've got some nice clouds reflecting in the water. Looks a little bit weird. But if I say okay, this reflections are an exception to the rule of thirds, now I've got the clouds in the sky reflecting in the water with my ice in the middle, and I have a beautifully composed shot. So that's a quick introduction to the rule of thirds and some of the tips that I give in this talk. For more information about it, please, or to arrange to hear it in full, please go to my website, www.sallygillies.com. Thank you.